He smokes, he drinks, he likes Sibelius. He's fortified, he's abject failures. Oh, when writing your novel, all you need to know is it's just Raymond Chandler with a lot more snow. To write a good book, the first in a thrilling series, a stiff is found in Stockholm near the Irish pub O'Leary's. The cadaver is that of Kirsten, a dancer in Mamma Mia. She's been horribly branded with names of the furniture ranges from IKEA. Baby, a Berkelantia, Asphalont. Our man drives the scene in his Volvo, being careful not to speed. And though it delays him, he buckles his seatbelt because he's a boring old Swede. He tracks his suspect to Malmo while an endless deluge of sleet falls. Meanwhile, in a processing factory, more bodies are found in a vat of meatballs. A noisy shootout leaves our protagonist temporarily deaf. And book one ends when we work out the killer must be the Muppet Chef. Put the chicken in the pit. Let's write celebrity bio about your rise to national stardom. How you grew up in Romford, Essex, a dead end life that you have come so far from. Your fledgling career was soon on fire. You were named best bum in July's Esquire. There's a Chinese symbol tattooed on your wrist. You think it says peace, but it really says piss. Oh, include lots of shots of you in slippery clothes. It will obviate the need to write too much prose.
To write a good book, and the first book's only a taster. Your mum was a one-legged lesbian who conceived with a turkey baster. You had destiny singled you out, a dancer, maybe a singer, and ignored all those jeering Jezebels who called you a slangy old minger.
Slangy old minger!
You won the heart of the nation in a reality show about slappers, were captured on film with Ashley Cole being sausage like the clappers. And you had your boobs implanted, had them removed, then wished you'd kept them. Told the surgeon to give you Britney's nose when he had to rebuild your septum. And now you stand to make millions. Well, the tabloids have gone mad, cos hobby number three turns out is your biological dad.
Let's write a nice sexy novel to flock to lots of yummy mommies. Don't make the bondage too explicit, or an S&M manual for the dummies. One man meets a student and bursts her dam by prizing open her bearded clam. Her inner goddess is a running commentary as her inlet of love receives his promontory. Oh, he takes her in the atrium and up against the door, which will tighten up the muscles on her pelvic floor.
To write a good book, one that's shamelessly commercial, take a 23-year-old virgin, unbelievable, controversial. She encounters a hunk who promises her a life of sexual bliss if she agrees to sign a contract to be totally submissive. How kind of you to let me come. At first the offer is tempting, she agrees to play along, especially when she discovers he has a truly enormous schlong. When he hoists her up in the handcuffs, her protests sound a bit hollow, and in spite of her inexperience, she magically knows how to swallow. At the end of the book, she walks away because the beatings are hard to forgive. Then you realize there are two more books, and you lose the will to live.
So live, that's the kind of shite you write. Then give yourself three cheers, cause you set the will.
least 100 years.